title of this speaker is Past Imperfect Present Tense. Past Imperfect Present Tense by Toastmaster Ravi Kumar. Mr. Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, and welcome guests, including esteemed reporter and cameraman. First, let me assure, I'm not going to give you grammar lessons. Past imperfect present tense, in short, epitomizes my life till now. For the icebreaker, I had a tough time pondering what is so worthwhile in my life to share with you all. But still, I'll go ahead and give you glimpses of a confused yet kaleidoscopic growing up years. After doing somersaults for 9 months in my mother's womb, I decided it was time to come out and set the world on fire. 21st of October 1981, a momentous day in world history. Star was born. Star, not exactly. Tube light is more appropriate. Because it clicked, it sputtered, and it did glow sometimes. The moment I was pulled out into this world from my mother, I found myself held into the hands of an ugly looking doctor. He had big moustache, thick glasses, and bushy eyebrows. One look at him and I was so shocked I couldn't speak for the next 2 years. Fast forward 8 years hence, class 5, section E, DAV Public School, Bhubaneswar. 11:30 a.m. The recess bell rings. I frantically close all my books, keep it into my bag, take my tiffin box out, go to the dustbin, empty my tiffin box, come back again, keep the tiffin box in my bag, run all the way down the stairs, onto the field, and onto the end of the field under that banyan tree. Following me, my boys of my class running as fast as they can. By the time we reach there, the students of section B are already there. Both students of both the section formed a circle. And the whistle was blown. I from section E and the other boy from section B took center stage. For the next 20 minutes, what followed was kicks and boxes and rolling on ground. Amidst cheering and hooting from the supporters of both the sections. After 20 minutes, I got up. Puffing and panting, bruises all over my body, still wearing the confident and triumphant smile. Friends, that was the fight club of my school and I had won. Fast forward 5 years hence, 4 years hence, class 9, same school, corridor of DAV Public School. From the other end, a group of girls coming towards me and I on the other end. The moment I see them, I freeze. I sense I'm the only boy in the corridor. Instinctively, I feel like turning back and leaving the place, but I don't. I put my head down and shyly cross those giggling girls, never raising my hand. Friends, inexplicably, the confident and mischievous boy of class 5 had grown to become shy, bumbling, and awkward guy of class 9. Fast forward 6 years hence. Barista, a spanky new mall in Gurgaon. The lad has turned 21. He is sipping coffee with his first date. The shy lad of class 9 has grown confident enough to ask a girl out. Friends, this in short tells you about my external metamorphosis. Now, let me share you some deeper aspects of my personality. An average student all through my life, a constant worry for my parents whether I will be able to do something out of my life. I realized that I had cognizance of it, and then lately I thought I will barge into anything and everything that will come my way and do everything that I can do. I started reading a lot because that gave me solace from the battling world outside. I started writing a lot and blogging a lot to vent out my angst against this world. I walked on the ramp with a group of young boys and girls last year when I was in Bangalore. I also did a stage performance with the choreograph troupe in my previous company. Last year in October, In short, I have turned my life into a canvas and I am filling it with as many colors as possible. Because I heard someone say, when you die, your whole life flashes in front of you. Make it worth watching. I have been trying to do the same lately. Toastmaster.
Toastmaster Ravi, can you tell us more details about your first date, please?
Alright, so Toastmaster Ravi has been to 2 dates or more than that, that we have to figure out after the break.